And give me Revelation 14 and 1.
Revelation chapter 14, verse 1. And I looked, and lo, a lamb stood on the Mount Zion.
And that lamb is talking about Yahushua. Go ahead.
And with him, 144,000.
144,000. That's the cabinet, if you will, of the nation of Israel. Because the one-third of Israel starts with the 144,000, which is 12,000 out of each tribe. All right? Hold that and go to Revelation 7 and 1.
This is Revelations chapter 7, verse 1. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree.
And that's that destruction, that nuclear destruction. Go ahead.
And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living power.
And the seal is not I'm good. The seal is not the Morgan David, you know, the 6-point star. That's not the seal. All right, you got guys teaching that's the seal. And he came down with a Morgan David. Yeah. You know, bullshit, man. Go ahead.
And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying,
How was it given unto the angels to hurt the earth and the sea? By nuclear destruction. Go ahead.
Saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our power in their foreheads.
And you know what? I was thinking about this for the last couple of weeks. We pretty much about sealed, man. The Most High about sealed everybody that's supposed to be sealed. Because 144,000 is not a lot of, it's not a big number, you know? Go ahead.
And I heard the number of them which were sealed. And there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of the children of Israel. Of the tribe of Judah were sealed 12,000.
So it ain't going to be where the majority of the elect is Judah. It's going to be broken up. 12,000 out of Judah. Go ahead.
Of the tribe of Reuben were sealed 12,000.
Go ahead.
Of the tribe of Gad were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Asher were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Naphtali were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Manasseh were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Simeon were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Levi were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Issachar were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Zebulun were sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Joseph were sealed 12,000.
Now stop right there, the tribe of Joseph. Now there's no such thing as the tribe of Joseph. Give me, I believe that's Numbers 1 and 32. I was going to say 32 and 1. Numbers 1 and 32. And then from there, go to Ezekiel 37 and 16.
I got Numbers if you want to.
Go ahead, bring it on out.
So number
32, yep.
Numbers chapter 1, verse 32. Of the children of Joseph, namely, of the children of Ephraim.
So, what was he talking about? Namely, of the children of Ephraim. Okay? Because out of Joseph, he had two principal sons, Ephraim and Manasseh. Manasseh was the firstborn, but what happened was when he went to bring the two boys for Jacob to bless him, he put his hand, his right hand on Manasseh's head, and then he put the other hand on Ephraim's head, all right? Well, actually, the right hand on Ephraim's head, and then the left hand on Manasseh. So Joseph said, "No, this is the older child." But he said, "No, he's going to be great, but Ephraim is going to be greater." All right, go ahead. Read it again.
Okay. Numbers 1 and 32. Of the children of Joseph, namely of the children of Ephraim, by their generations, after their families, by the house of their fathers, according to the number of the names from 20 years old and upward, all that were able to go forth to war.
Mm-hmm.
This is Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 16. Moreover, thou son of man, take thee one stick and write upon it for Judah and for the children of Israel, his companions.
Now, what is that talking about? That's why we got this sign up here. Okay? If you see an Israelite group and they don't have this sign, then the Most High is not dealing with them. You got Judah. The companions of Judah was Benjamin and Levi. Okay? Go ahead.
Then take another stick and write upon it for Joseph.
Joseph, which is Ephraim. Go ahead.
The stick of Ephraim.
The stick of Ephraim. Go ahead.
And for all the house of Israel, his companions.
Who are the companions of Ephraim? The other so-called Latin tribes. Gad, you know. Go ahead.
And join them one to another into one stick.
Now, when you read that word stick, in the Hebrew, the word is plank. This is a plank right here. So we're fulfilling prophecy when we bring this sign out, man. So it said Judah and his companions and Ephraim and his companions and join them all into one stick.
Stick of wood.
Plank. The word is plank.
Yep.
And this is actually a plank. Exactly.
Yep.
Go ahead, Ark.
And they shall become one in thine hand.
And aren't they one? The sign is in my hand. The plank is in my hand. Aren't they one? Because you got other Israelite groups out there that they say, well, the Puerto Ricans and North American Indians, they're not Israelites. Only Judah. I remember Yahweh ben Yahweh. Before I came into the truth, I spoke to them. There was Yahweh ben Yahweh people all around. They were big. So I said, well, can I be down with this? So they said, well, what's your father? And at that time I said, West Indian or whatever. I said, no, you can't be. Only Judah. You got to be a Negro. No, the Lord ain't dealing with West Indians. He ain't dealing with Haitians. He ain't dealing with Puerto Rico. Where are they now? Yeah. Yahweh ben Yahweh is gone. It's done. Where they at?
Yeah, Yahweh.
Go ahead.
And when the children of thy people shall speak unto thee, saying, Wilt thou not show us what thou meanest by these?
So when they say, a lot of people come up and even Edomites, they don't look around and look at the sign. What's the sign all about? Why ain't on that sign? Then you got to explain it to them. Like if a Nigerian came up and said, where's the Nigerians at? I would say, well, the Nigerians will most likely be Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. Judah, I would say, you know?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Say unto them, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I will take the stick of Joseph, which is in the hand of Ephraim.
Ephraim, go ahead.
In the tribes of Israel, his fellows, and will put them with him, even with the stick of Judah, and make them one stick, and they shall be one in mine hand. And the sticks whereon thou writest shall be in thy hand before their eyes.
Isn't it before your eyes and in my hands? So that's a fulfillment of prophecy. Like I said, any Israelite group that's out there teaching about Israel, and they don't got this sign, they're not, the Most High ain't dealing with them. Okay?
Fringes too.
Yohanna. Yohanna's men don't wear fringes more.
Bubble eyes too. They don't wear the fringes.
They don't wear the fringes no more, you know?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Verse 20. In the sticks whereon thou writest shall be in thine hand before their eyes. And say unto them, thus saith the Lord thy power, behold, I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen, whither they be gone, and will gather them on every side.
Aren't they being gathered on every side? So this is prophecy, man. And these elite Edomites, they get nervous, man. Y'all didn't see the trailer for Nat Turner?
Oh, yeah.
Man, I can't wait till that movie come out, man.
It's going to be bad sweat today.
Go ahead.
And bring them into their own land.
Oh, so ultimately what's going to happen? They're going to be brought into their own land, which is the land of Israel. All right? Go ahead.
And I will make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king to them all. And they shall be no more two nations, neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms anymore
now
at all.
They're going to set up one king over them, right? That one king is King David, but then the king over him is Yehoshaphat.
Always.
Just going to say whatever comes to my mind. The first thing I'm going to say is, you fucking Edomites, you're in a lot of goddamn trouble. Because you didn't just take any old nation and enslave them and put us under your feet, but you did it to sovereigns, the children of Israel. And Yasha Allah, Yah meaning he, Shah meaning prince, which is royal, sovereign, Allah meaning power or God. We are the princes of God, and you enslaved us for a period of more than 400 years. So what in the fuck do you think you're going to get in return? You're going to get cold fucked up. We're going to kick your ass. We're going to break you up. We're going to fuck you up. We're going to work you in the fields. We're going to work your ass every day. And you ain't going to get no fucking bread. You ain't going to have no shift, man. If we decide to make your motherfucking ass work 2-3 days straight, you going to do it, bitch. You going to do it, you motherfuckers. You got that time is on our side, not your side, man. You can do whatever you want, but you better do it fucking quick. Because your time is up, man.